Rheumatologists, we have got very good medications for the control of rheumatoid arthritis, which aim at control of disease, improvement of quality of life for the patient, so they can lead a painless and a deformity-free life. So they can think about that. So the main treatments that are available today are mainly focusing on the control of the immune system, the so-called immunomodulators. We also call them DMARDs, D-M-A-R-Ds, which are basically disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs. So there are many of them. For example, methotrexate, hydroxychloroquine, leflunomide, sulfasalazine, and many other newer drugs called biologics, which are very targeted therapies which work beautifully in a given patient and which can control disease for us in a very easy manner. Steroids, a lot of people are apprehensive about steroid use in rheumatoid arthritis. Steroids we use for a short duration, maybe about 3 to 4 months in the beginning of the illness, where steroids can achieve very good disease control for us. But in the long term, we want to maintain the disease in control without steroids. So that is our goal. And steroids are there only for a short term and not for long term use. So I don't think anybody should be apprehensive about steroids. Reasons why rheumatoid arthritis happens in a patient. So in such a situation, we cannot really recommend measures to prevent rheumatoid arthritis. The best thing to what we would suggest is never to smoke, and if you are into the habit of smoking, quit it now. Other than that, maintain a healthy lifestyle. Always have a good exercise regimen. Exercise at least for 30 minutes, a minimum of 5 times a day, to keep yourself fit. The best prevention for rheumatoid arthritis would be to treat it if at all it develops. If somebody is unfortunate enough to develop that disease, we need to detect it early and treat it early so that they can lead a normal life and not, you know, get bogged down by the disease.